Having your intent to file prior, so before these changes, is the absolute best spot, and I'm not joking about that, to be in when it comes to mental health, tinnitus, and sleep apnea, and I'm going to explain why. I'm also going to show you the M21, how the VA makes decisions, and what they have to say. So the VA must take the higher criteria of old and new. So if you would have rated for 70% for mental health under the old criteria, but now under the new criteria, you rate 50% because your intent to file was prior to that change, the VA must award you that 70%. Now, this really is going to apply to sleep apnea more than any of them, because right now for obstructive sleep apnea and those apnea episodes using your CPAP, right now it's rated at a solid 50% right now. Now, the new criteria, that same situation, obstructive sleep apnea with a CPAP, is going to rate 0%, which is complete garbage, and we all know that. But having your intent to file prior to that change will save your VA rating, and you absolutely need to stay on top of these rating changes for that reason. Mental health, tinnitus, and sleep apnea are extremely common claims. The worst thing that can happen is you have your intent to file and you do nothing with it. Now, yes, April 2025 is just a placeholder. Got it. I hear you. But you have to use that as a planning factor. Do not discount. Do not let stupid YouTube comments discount that April 2025 does not matter, because it does. Use it as a planning factor. So when this does come into effect, just like GERD and IBS changes did, everyone's going to freak out, and I'm going to sit here and say, I told you so. You should have had your intent to file ready to go. Now, don't take my word for it. I'm just a dude in his basement who makes YouTube videos. Let's go ahead and pull up the M21 TAC 1, which guides how the VA makes decisions. That part is key on both the old and new criteria. So here we go. This is navigating the M21 TAC 1 is difficult. That I think is done for a reason by the VA, but I'll kind of not go into the conspiracy realm. So part 5, subpart 2, we have 3D2 alpha. Determining the retroactive applicability of a new statute or regulation, so a change to the VA schedule of ratings. So the provisions of a statutory or regulatory change to rating schedule criteria, that's what we're talking about here, mental health, tinnitus, and sleep apnea, for evaluating disabilities are generally not retroactive, meaning the change is not retroactive, which is good. That's what we're talking about. Unless retroactive applicability is specifically directed. So for instance, let's just hypothetically say GERD IBS goes into effect on May 19th, April 1st, anything from April 1st to May 19th is going to be retroactive. So if the change doesn't say that, you're good to go. When a change that revises the rating schedule's evaluation criteria does not specify the intent for retroactive application, that's what we just talked about, assume that the new criteria do not apply prior to the effective date of the corresponding regulatory change. Is that legal mumbo jumbo? Yes. What it means is if you have your intent to file on April 1st of 2024, right? Let's just say January 1st to make it easy. January 1st, 2025, the change happens April 1st, 2025. You're going to fall under both old and new criteria. So note, for claims pending on the date that a rating schedule provision is changed, it's usually appropriate to apply the, you can see how there's both here, right? Old, new, I'm not making this up. Old regulation in assigning disability evaluations for periods that precede the date of the change. So your intent to file, or you've already filed that claim, is being developed. New regulation in evaluating a disability for any period that begins on or after the date of the change. So May 19th for GERD and IBS, that's new regulation. Intent to file is prior to May May 18th and prior falls under the old. And now listen to this. A higher evaluation must be based on the new regulation. But the new regulatory criteria cannot be applied to reduce an evaluation unless actual improvement is discussed. And that's whenever you get into the grandfather clause of protection. So yes, the VA must award you the higher evaluation based on the new regulation. So if the new regulation has you at 0% for sleep apnea, but the old regulation has you at 50% for that same disability, the higher evaluation will apply. Could the M21 be plain language? Yes, I agree with you, okay? I've spoken to a few raters. One of them is a senior rater, and it's confirmed the VA must take the higher evaluation. So that's for mental health, tinnitus, and sleep apnea, which we don't really have a solid date yet. Let's go ahead and use GERD and IBS because we know we have a date. It's May 19th, 2024. It already happened. It happened already, okay? So if you had your intent to file January 1st and you never really filed for GERD, but after May, you did file for GERD because you saw YouTube videos about the changes. So you filed for GERD, and really under hiatal hernia, you would have rated 30%, but under esophageal stricture, you rate 10%. The new criteria is esophageal stricture. The old criteria is hiatal hernia. What will the VA do? Okay, we have a 30% old, 10% new. The VA must award you the 30% because your intent to file falls within the old regulation. Now, the instant you do not have that intent to file or you do not submit because of whatever reason and you're in the new criteria, that's it. I don't care when your diagnosis was. I don't care when you wanted to file the claim. If you do not have in law that intent to file in VA law, VA policy, that intent to file, it doesn't matter. You're going to fall under the new criteria. And we saw that happen a lot with GERD. Now, GERD and IBS was slightly different because the old criteria also roped GERD and IBS as one. So that was another factor that determined, okay, you would have rated 30% for GERD and IBS under the old criteria, assuming you have both, but 10% for GERD under the new criteria, but 30% for IBS under the new criteria. So 30 old, 10 and 30 new. Now the VA must award you the new criteria. There we go. Okay, M21 part 5, subpart 2. Chapters, whatever, you could read that. It's very hard to read that. But there you go. Don't take my word for it. That's M21 Tac 1.